I hope you'll go along with this rather unusual setting and the fact that I remain seated when I get introduced, and the fact that I'm going to come to you mostly through this medium here for the rest of the show. If in your office, you as an intellectual worker, were supplied with a computer display backed up by a computer that was alive for you all day and was instantly responsive to every action you had, how much value could you derive from that? So I'm putting in an entity called a statement, and that's full of other entities called words. Through with this example right now, let me go to a file that I prepared just after my wife called me and said, on the way home, would you do a little shopping for me? So as soon as she said that, I got my system organized. And made a shopping list. So I put a few items on it. We have a pointing device called our mouse, a standard keyboard, and a special key set we have here. And we're going to go for a picture down in our laboratory in Menlo Park and pipe it up. That'll show you from another point of view more about how that mouse works. Come in, Menlo Park. Okay, there's Don Andrews' hand in Menlo Park. And in a second, we'll see the screen that he's working and the way the tracking spot moves in conjunction with movements of that mouse. I don't know why we call it a mouse. Sometimes I apologize. It started that way, and we never did change it. Provides for you the one-hand equivalent of what you can do with a keyboard. There are five keys, and normally each finger sits on a key, and depressing any one key at a time produces a character. And any two keys at a time also. And in fact, any... monstrous history of this monstrous world, monstrously different knowledge. I'd like to really say that I'm backed up by a really very tremendous team of these 17 guys who have caught the spirit of putting on this show tremendously and just done an overwhelming job about putting it all together. And about backing me all these years in this wild dream of doing this sort of thing. And they're all catching fire, and I want to just tell them all right now, I owe them a lot. And a very final credit goes to my wife and daughters who are out here, to whom I'd like to dedicate this whole presentation because of what they've put up with over these years, with a husband that dedicated in a monomaniacal way to something very wild. And so this whole presentation is dedicated to you four people there, and I thank all the rest of you very much for coming to the dedication ceremony.